بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ويلكم تو ذا مشرق يونيفرسيتي بلاتفورمز كوليدج اوف انجينيرنج الكترونيك انجينيرنج ديبارتمنت فيس اكاديميك سير الكترونيكس انجينيرنج كورس اوبريتنج سيستم انجينيرنج ليكتشر توبكس انتدكشن تو ذا كورس انتدكشن تو اوبريتنج سيستم ليكتشر توبكس كونتنتس اند مين توبكس ليت اس تو ستارت ويز بريف A description about course and lecture topics. The first topics should be discussed operating system definition. Next one is an operating system goals, and the third topics is operating system components, while last one let us to see a case study of types of an operating system. Operating system definition. There are three standard operating system definitions. The first definition, operating system can be defined as intermediate program. So, an operating system act as intermediate between user and computer hardware. Another definition is a control program. So, an operating system that act as a control program, which controls the execution of user programs to prevent error and improve use of computer system and devices. The third definition of an operating system is a resource allocators. So an operating system can be defined as resource allocators, such as hardware resources, input and output device, processor, memory, while software resources such as file and folders. So, an operating system can be work or defined as resource allocator, which can be basic for resources allocation and deallocation, use and disuse based on some types of conditions and codes. Now let us to brief explain an operating system goals in this slide. An operating system goals can be defined in short point. The first goal is execute user programs, which supports the user to execute apps and other types of programs. Another goal is make solving user problem easier and support user for problem solving with easy way. Next goal is computer system conventions to be used and easy to recognize operating task and functions. Another task is use the computer hardware in an efficient manner in contact with time and memory required. The next one, isolate users from hardware peculiarities. So this can great help that provided by users of the system to isolate user for difficulties and peculiarities of hardware. In this slide, discuss about operating system standard components, which construct a system and provide interface between hardware and software. The first components of system view is the hardware that provide basic computer resources such as microprocessor, memory, I/O device, and other electronics hardware components. The next basic component is an operating system itself, which controls and coordinates the use of the hardware among the various applications program for various users. The third part of an system component is apps or application programs. The application program defines the way in which the system resources are used to solve the computer problems of the user, for example, compilers, database, system videos, games, and business program for support single use of system or multi or networks user systems. The last component is the user itself, which is recognized as view by the operating system as components of the system. So user itself can be used as people or machine or other components. Now let us to explain an operating system components as brief diagrams shown as these slides providing by multi layers. The top layers is user, for example single use or multi user, user 1, user 2 up to user n, the top level of the system components. The intermediate level is the system apps or applications program, for example compiler, assembler, text editor or database. Each user can contact easy with specific types of applications, while the third levels is an operating system layers. Brief explaining the level of these components, such as operating system itself, where is intermediate between an applications program and the first one level, user 1 and user 2, up to the low level or most low level, the computer hardware. So an operating system can interact easy with the apps and with hardware, or with the top level user 1 up to n user. Operating system definition. Let us to continue the defines of an operating system by the first standard definition, resource allocators. Resource allocators mainly can be described as manage and allocate resources based on three conditions: types of resources, software or hardware resource, also events and conditions that interact the resources states, and resource use and reuse for allocate and reallocate device. Meaning allocate is to set user hardware, and reallocate is to define as free point. Another definition of an operating system is control programs can be explained as control the executions of user programs, control operations of input and output device hardware such as printer, keyboard and mouse, or other types of operating system resources, input and output device. While kernels is a defined of an operating system, also an operating system can be classified as the kernels. The kernel is one program running at all times, an operating system run all times, while all else programs, beings and apps programs or applications program run for some times and to be exit by end of task. Now let us to take points about types of an operating system based on three types can be using as case study. The first one is the mainframe system. Mainframe system is all types of an operating system or traditional types of operating system. The mainframe features can be explained in tick points to reduce startup time by batching similar job work together. So the switching between jobs and jobs can be reduced by these times required for running. And also automatic job sequencing, the conditions to recognize first job and next job can be switching automatically. So automatic transfer control from one job to another job can do also by the mainframe great features. To use the resident monitor support resident programs in main memory to support the interactions between jobs and frames in mainframe operating system. So these features initiate control in monitor, initiate the startup of main and stop job. Also use control transfer from the first job to next job up to the end of the last job to be executed by the operating system main frame. When job completed, control transfer back to the monitors by using the event condition to transact to another job. Memory layouts in batch system, memory interaction, and segmentation to support layout in batch system can be worked in two styles of memory, batch system and single system. The first one is the memory layout for simple batch system, for example, divided memory area into two sections, the upper section providing the operating system layers, and the next one is the user program area. These two sections used by share the memory system to support an operating system and user programs. In multi-program batch system, can use the another segmentation for a memory job. The upper memory provided to isolated operating system area top level, and the next segment of memory can be divided to mount all jobs, job 1 up to job n, as shown in the next diagram. So several jobs are kept in memory at the same times. This great providing by memory batch system layout. The next case study is multi-programming operating system. Multi-programming operating system basically is a type of operating system that provide execute of multiple number of programs can be worked in same times. So these features supported or needed some feature to be driving an operating system. In these slides, we are discuss about operating system features needed for multi programming. So an IO subroutine supplied by the system must be needed. Input and output subroutine is a brief programs that supply to interact and control the executions of input device or output device. Components operate support by the layer of multi-programming system. So to initiate support or initiator supporting, the initializations is the starting of subroutine to check the number of I/O available and the types of hardware the supported file needed to be run, and also the conditions of ready or busy, such as printers or keyboard or other types of I/O device. Another support is connection and interface, which connect and check the connection board for printers or networking, and the interface condition if the hardware device is available and if it's ready to be used for a specific task. Another need for a multi-programming system is a memory management providing by the system, so must allocate the memory to several job, divided memory system or memory space to mount several job by allocate every job to every conditions of memory based on the types of memory itself, the conditioning for space at the memory, and the resolve standard addressing mode. Also memory management providing the free space management for easy use and memory system interaction. While loading new apps or new job, free space decrement, and while exit or conditioning a system, we use free space as a managing device. Another types of needing support for multi programming is CPU scheduling. Scheduling concept is the construction timing to run the microprocessor to support multi task to be run. For example, choose among several jobs to be run, and also using the scheduling methods or algorithm that control the scheduling variables and scheduling conditions to be switching from job and job, and share the execution time among the microprocessor to run every jobs by conditioning timings of executions. So scheduling performance measures should be take place to select which is the best way and best algorithm for schedulings to reduce the delay times and the interaction number of operating system multitask can be done at the same times. Last point for needed for multi-programming is allocations of device. Means that allocation is take conditions and control to use and mount device and providing for a specific user. For example, in networking, take the printer and associated control to a specific user to be print out job and switching back the printers to the operating system and mounting to another user at the network. This process called the allocations of device. So this based on device state, the state of hardware device, if it interface, if it have to be run, if it be ready to do task, and if it at fail state. For example, a device uses control as brief. Another case of operating system types is the time sharing system, which provide the sharing execution times between system of device, or briefly can be defined as interactive computing. So time share good providing features such as a time sharing system main feature. The first stick point for this feature is a microprocessor multiplexed among several jobs that are kept in memory and on a disk. So microprocessor devices should be several tick points for jobs and kept in main memory by using scheduling time to execute all these job by time execution. So this time shares providing the run times to be shared between jobs. So the microprocessor allocates to job only if the job in memory. A job is swapped in out and out of memory to a disk by providing the scenario of loading between disk and memory up to assigning the processor device. Online communications between the users and system should be take place to interaction between communication pathway and the user of the system to support and approach of some jobs by execution in sometimes to be uploading to the memory device. Online communication is providing when the operating system finished the executions of one command and need to switch to the another. It seeks the next control statement to known well which is used by this time to next job. This providing by the algorithm of schedulings, indexing the statement to determine carefully support the operating system to know at any times the first job to be executed, the next one and the last job to be executed. So it can be switching from job to another by these types of use. Online system must be available for a user to access data and code among the several types of storage device and operating system support.